Hello, my name's Joanne James and welcome to another tutorial from The Crafty Owl. Today I'm going to show you how to make an envelope using your envelope punch board, but it's actually to make an envelope of an irregular size. So the punch board itself has markings for 66 different envelope sizes. The board comes with the standard inch markings, or if you like to work in metric, there's a metric overlay which you can stick on top. I actually don't stick mine on because I like to be able to use both depending on what size card I'm making. And as I say, the board itself provides you with 66 different measurements, but sometimes there's a need to make a card that is an unusual size. So I previously developed a really successful neat tool called Boxbuster, which you can find on my website at www.thecraftyowl.co.uk/boxbuster, which enables you to build a box of any size using your Stampin' Up! Envelope punch board. Following the development of Boxbuster, I've had lots and lots of inquiries for a similar tool that will allow you to build an envelope of any size. And whilst I don't often make envelopes outside of the standard markings on the board, sometimes I too find myself needing to do that. So we've kind of gone back a step, and now I've created a similar tool, this time called Envelope Expert. So this short video is going to show you how it works. So I made a card. This is the card I made here, and this card actually measures 20 centimetres. I'm working in millimetres today, so actually 200 millimetres, can you just see there, by, across the top there, whoops, 105 millimetres. So 200 by 105 millimetres, and that's not a standard size. So if you look on the metric plate for the board, you can have 10.5, but you can only have it by 14.8. You can't have it by 20, because that kind of size ratio doesn't exist. So I'll show you using Envelope Expert how we get those measurements. Envelope Expert can be found at www.thecraftyowl.co.uk, either /envelope expert or go to the Tools menu and select the Envelope Expert drop-down menu. The Envelope Expert page looks like this. You simply input your envelope width into the first box, so for this card 105 mm, followed by the envelope height, so for this card 200 mm, and once you've selected your unit of measurement, simply click on the calculate button and the tool tells us the paper size and punch mark that we require. Envelope Expert tells us that for a card that measures 200 millimetres by 105 millimetres, we need a piece of paper that measures 244 millimetres square. So I've already cut my paper to size, and if I just show you here, that measures 244 millimetres. Same on this side. 244 millimetres, and the Envelope Expert tells us that we need to make our punch mark at 156 millimetres. Now, the ruler on the board only goes up to 130, so you have to get a little bit creative with your ruler, but you can align an ordinary ruler to the ruler on the board, and what you need to do is pop your paper over the top to 156. Hold your paper in place over here and then just remove your ruler and then simply punch and score. And thereafter, it's really easy because all you're going to do now is rotate your paper, align to the score line you've already done, punch and score. It goes off the page slightly, but don't worry too much about that. That's because obviously it's a large envelope. You can still align your score line, punch and score. And then do the same on the last side, punch and score. And there, in essence, you have your envelope shape. All you need to do is round your corners like so. We can just put our board to one side. And if we fold our envelope in, you will see that it is the perfect size for the card that I've made. So we just pop our card inside. This is purely to show you that it fits. We'll see. And there you go. One envelope to size for an unusually sized shape card. So that's how easy it is. Obviously, we want to be able to just stick that together. I actually quite like to use these two-way glue pens when you're sticking envelopes because they just enable you to put just the right amount of glue without any overlaps. Just pop that like that and stick it down. And the other thing to note is that this flap here obviously does fit within the width of the card, but sometimes if your card is particularly long and narrow, this may extend over the top, and all you'll need to do is just trim it off slightly so that you don't have too much of an overlap. But there you go, there's the envelope for my unusually sized card. You can make envelopes of any size and shape using my new tool, the Envelope Expert, which you can find at www.thecraftyowl.co.uk/envelope-expert. I hope you find this tutorial useful, and come back next time for another tutorial from The Crafty Owl. Thanks, goodbye.